Welcome back to Ration Nerd, everybody. Thanks for coming back to the channel to spend some time with me to check out some of this old and crusty, I mean, this stuff that we like to eat, these ration things. So this is a food packet survival general purpose, kind of tying in to some of these other ones that I've been doing. We're gonna pop this key off of there. Now, there are some rust marks on this can. I am hoping that we get a nice, I'm hoping that this thing gives us a hiss when we open it, because that means that no air got in, but I just can't guarantee that at all. So this is pretty cool. This one's a first for me. So I'm really hoping. So I'm going to shut up now so we can hear it. Nope, that didn't make any noise. So, okay. All right. Fine, don't be fresh. Be skanky and nasty, fine. I guess only the nose and the taste buds will be able to tell. It's a real shame that they put it's a real shame that they put that line right down the center where it's gonna be kinda hard to keep this as a showpiece. You know, I kinda like this stuff. I save ration bags and boxes. I'd like to save this one too. Ooh. All right, I'm gonna sit that little key off to the side. There's our cool little tin top. What do we have here? A not so vacuum sealed container of Food Bar survival chicken flavored artificial. Oh no, see, it's got cornmeal, which maybe would survive the shortening. The shortening is gonna make this thing super rancid, I'm thinking. But we shall see. We'll figure it out together. See how not vacuum sealed that thing was. Just kind of opened right up. That's not cool. So now we have a cornflake bar survival type 1. And that's a 2-ounce survival bar. Made by the Van Brode Milling Company Incorporated. In, looks like, Clinton, Massachusetts. Nice. And then we have another, well, this is rice-cornflake bar survival type. Yeah, these things are not vacuum sealed. What a total bummer. I was really, really hoping these things were going to be good and edible. We'll still give it. We'll give it hell. That's what we're going to do. Instant coffee. See? Look, back in 1966, they were doing it right. It's finally making some noise. Instant coffee. That's what I'm talking about. That's survival right there. Screw the bars. Give me the coffee. So now we have a chocolate fudge bar. That still feels kind of pliable. That packaging is not all that great, but there's that guy. We have a packet of sugar. That's definitely... not still granulated, it's just kind of like one big hunk of sugar. What do we have here? That's the end of it right there. That's a cool little tin. I really wish we could have got that open and kept it completely intact. That's pretty neat. What is this weird pack? Soup and gravy based chicken flavor. Well, we're really taking my life in our hands today. Let me tell you what. So, I was going to say let's get this out onto a tray and look at it, but we're just going to go with it as is. I don't really think this needs a tray. I mean, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to eat too much of this stuff. So, let's take a look at this coffee. I mean, because Lord knows I will need something to drink. I don't think this coffee is going to be okay. It's probably dry molded. I don't know. I mean, I'm not really sure. It's kind of hard to see. I guess I could let you guys look. What do you think? The guy looks good? Who knows? Oh. I'm just like dropping stuff. It's not even cool. All right, so let's get some of this coffee made up. Let's check out this 6 grams of granulated sugar. Actually, you know, that is still granulated. All right, maybe there's hope. There might just be hope. Let's check out this coffee. Get all that 1966 goodness out of there. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, wow. We're just going to make a little baby cup of coffee. Because that wasn't really a lot of coffee to begin with. We're just going to make a little baby cup. Now, obviously, this thing, you saw what was in there. It doesn't come with a spoon, so we had to bring in some help, which is totally fine. All right, some 1966 Brew Especial right here. Should like say a couple of like Hail Mary, Full of Grace and all. Okay, let me okay, that smells normal. No weird smells going on. You know what? That's not too shabby. A little bitter. Could honestly use more than 6 grams of sugar for that probably 4 ounce cup of coffee I'm rocking right now. But you know what? That actually tastes like coffee. No numb or weird tingly feelings in my mouth, so there's probably maybe sorta isn't any food poisoning in there. I'll after action report you guys. If you never see this video, or if shortly after this video posts on Wednesday, I just drop off the face of YouTube, you know what happened to me. You know what? That is an impressive cup of coffee. Really not that bad. A little bitter. A little bit acidic. Could use some more sugar. I probably could add some more water to it, but you know what? That tastes pretty damn good. And I'm happy about it. That is what I'm expecting to see in a survival ration. Give me the coffee. And they totally did. Thank you very much. Now we'll move on to the probably less than appetizing portion of this, which is checking out these bars. I'm hoping against hope. Oh, it's just open. Oh, it's just delaminated. Oh. All right. Okay. So I'm going to have to just stuff my face in here and get a little sniff check on this. Oh. Oh yeah. So the shortening in that has absolutely gone rancid. Good God almighty. Let me get another. I'm going to smell it again even though I don't really want to. I kind of have to smell it again so I can explain it to you. It's really hard to even explain that. It no longer smells like corn flakes at all. It doesn't smell like any grain. It doesn't smell sweet. It smells old and weird. I really can't even, you know, I usually have a pretty good time translating like what something smells like or tastes like into something that maybe you guys can, you know, understand. Not that you're dumb. Just that it's, you know, explaining the way something tastes or smells. Usually if you get something that everybody can kind of know what it smells or tastes like. Ugh. That smells so horrible. I'm going to take a bite. I don't know if I'm going to take a bite. I don't know. But let's try this. Get out this rice cornflake bar. Oh, shortening in these guys is like the worst idea. I wish. See, look, you don't even have to peel them open. They're just peeling open on their own. Like, they have completely delaminated at this point. That's such a bummer. If the air got in this can and forced this delamination, or if this is just a process of time. You know, I mean, this thing's got a couple of years on it at this point. So, I can't be mad at it for not surviving from 19. This feels greasy on the outside. It's so disgusting. I don't exactly know what that's all about. Trying to get it open without doing like too much damage to the bar. One, because I don't want the smell to permeate. and two, just because I want you guys to be able to see what it looks like when it comes out of the package. Let's see if this rice bar smells any better or worse. Smells about the same. Maybe a little lighter. Like this smells a lighter funk. All right, I gotta get you some kind of explanation. Okay. So anybody that's ever been in a boys' locker room in high school, and I can't tell you what the girls' locker room smelled like because, well, never been in one. So if you take a boys' locker room and you condense that smell and then take some wet newspaper and combine wet newspaper and boys' locker room together and like a just a tiny little, just a drop of bakery, like when you first walk into a bakery. So a little tiny drop of bakery and then a big spoonful of boys' locker room. Yeah, like all that just craziness mixed together. That is what those basically smell like. This one smells a little lighter on the gyms. Or this one is a little lighter on the locker room smell, I guess because of the rice. And that one's like full flavor high school locker room. Whew. Oh, yeah. I can only imagine this one's going to be just as bad. Although it doesn't seem... It does seem to be sealed a little better than the others. It's not just completely delaminating in any particular area. I will say I like the concept of these bars, especially being different flavors, like the modern version of this ration, the silver bagged one. You know, those bars were okay. Those bars were good, very unidimensional in flavor. That's the problem with that type of stuff. But it is survival food. At least some thought was given to this to try to please the person eating it. Is that green speck supposed to be there? Ooh. Ooh. Oh, God. You know, I was really hoping this would be a well-preserved example. You know, I don't know that it's possible to even have something from 1966 that's well-preserved. Because, you know, the packaging just wasn't designed to stick around that long. Let's take a look at that guy. Oh, yeah. That's sexy. That's sexy right there. It's very light. Yes, very light. Not very dense. These are a lot more dense and heavy. That's very light and airy. So let's check out this chocolate fudge bar. Now this being kind of... Oh, feels very moist and oily on the inside. That kind of scares me because, well, the higher moisture content is going to cause all kinds of fun things to grow in there. Decontaminate that knife. Oh, look at that guy. Ooh. Ooh. I mean, I bet you back in the day when this thing was fresh, it was probably pretty good. Oh. 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 God, that thing. I mean, that kind of smells like what it looks like. Like, it looks like a bar of Dookie, and it kind of smells like that right now. Oh, goodness. That's... Oh. Yeah. So, let me get some of this coffee, like, because that's probably all I'm getting out of this thing. I'm really surprised the coffee made it with all this stuff kind of degrading in this can. You never know, I might get violently ill later, so we'll have to see. Give you guys a little close-up of this soup and gravy base so you can take a look at that. Check your ingredients out on that guy. I'm not really sure. This packaging, though, is interesting compared to the others. You know, this looks kind of like a tri-laminate packaging. Has definitely stood up. Maybe that's just because it was in the bottom of the can, but it certainly doesn't seem to be peeling like the rest of this stuff does. So I'm wondering if this is still going to be good in any way, shape, or form. Oh. Holy f- Oh. Okay, that almost triggered my gag reflex. I mean, that made my mouth water in the worst possible way, like that pre-illness mouth watering. That is so rancid. Like, the only thing that probably kept this filth from getting all over everything else was the fact that this particular piece of packaging was pretty decent. That literally is smelling up the room right now. Like, that had a chicken vomit and feces smell all combined together. I'm not even going to bother to put that in a cup. That's super foul. So, I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm not going to give myself food poisoning. We're just going to go ahead and remove these items from the table. So, hey, it was fun opening this thing up, but obviously, I have to be alive to make another video. This is a cool keepsake. It was really cool to see what was in there. And even just to be able to open the can with a key like that was really nifty. I'm going to keep this as a keepsake. I'm kind of a ration hoarder like that. So, that was the food packet survival general purpose from 1966. Luck definitely ran out on that one. What are you gonna do? Can't control the conditions under which these are stored, and we're gonna just give it a go with food packet survival general purpose, and this one happens to be from 1990. I'm hoping we get better results out of this one. This one has a pull tab on top. This will be my first time ever seeing one of these from 1990. I don't think I've ever even seen somebody open them on YouTube unless my memory's just failing me. So this ought to be kind of fun. Vacuum sealed, return if ring is lifted. This is pretty awesome. I'm hoping that this guy stood the test of time. Only opening it will give us that answer. Oh, there was just a tiny little hiss on that one. That's good news. Uh-oh. And you know what? At least right off the bat, there are no funky smells. Everything's really packed in there, as you can imagine. Really, really packed in there. Maybe we'll get something edible. Ooh, granola. Granola bar. Granola bar. And you know what? If you get one of these, be careful. That interior edge where that peel top lid comes off is sharp as all get out. Those don't look so healthy. All right. Well, that's everything. Let's check it out. What do we have here? Coffee Instant Type 1. Does not sound like it's still in a powdered form. We have a whole bunch of sugar. So we have 3 packs of sugar at 6 grams each. We have an Urbox chicken flavored instant broth. That actually sounds like it's still powder. And we have these oatmeal cookies here that look like all of the shortening has moved to the surface, which is a real bummer, but we shall see. So, there you have it. You get some chicken bouillon. You get 18 grams of sugar. And because back in 1990 we cared about our troops, coffee. So that's it. I mean, to be honest with you, in that little can, that's not too shabby. So let's start by checking out one of these granola bars and see if this is going to be a total bust. So these do have a little bit of a greasy feel to the exterior. That doesn't really bode well, I'll be honest. It's probably the fat has like leaked through the packaging somehow. Oh, come on and be good. I want a bite. I want a bite. I don't know. I mean, that, aside from this really weird greasy texture going on, maybe they had to grease these up to get them in the can in the first place. I don't know. Maybe it's just like packing lube. Oh, 1990 to 2024. I mean, that's kind of a long time. It's just kind of falling apart. Like, I don't know, guys. I don't. Oh, the grease is. Oh, it's just falling apart. I don't know. Is that even normal? Oh. Oh no, that's rancid. Damn it. Oh. It's just it's really just falling apart. I'm going to take a tiny little bite because I have to bite something in two rations. I got to take a bite of something. There's got to be something for me to take a bite of first. Oh. All right. Ready to get your disgust meter on. So here's a little bite of this stuff. Let's... Oh, God. Shit. Okay, that was not... Oh!
Okay.
Oh, that's so foul. So, oh, okay. All right, so that... You first put that in your mouth. You first put that bite in your mouth, and just for a split second, I'm not sure if it's just your mind trying to make you believe that because it says granola bar, it's supposed to taste like a granola bar. You get this tiny little hint of like a sweet honey flavored, just plain granola bar, just for a second. And then that instantaneously switches over to the taste of vomit. No lie. As soon as your mouth gets over the granola fantasy, it tastes like vomit, and it just, wow. I mean, wow. So, we're not making that mistake again. I can say that these were probably good when they were actually still good. Like, this packaging is actually sticky, so I'm thinking that the oils in these have just gone completely super rancid, and this thing has just fallen apart inside of the package. Do not recommend trying this at home. Probably dumb for me to even have taken that bite. So if you are watching this and you're thinking about doing it, it's do not recommend at all in any way, shape, or form. Eating bad food is bad for you. There's your disclaimer. However, if you have an enemy that you really don't like, somebody that you really hate, just give him one of these. Like, hey, man, have a granola bar. Like, hey, customs, what are you doing? So, like, I'm thinking, like, if I have any overseas viewers right now, so, like, maybe I need to repackage this and just call it, like, meat bar. And so that way when customs gets it, they'll just, like, snatch it and be like, haha, I got his meat bar. And then they'll be in there having lunch, be like, hey, I'm going to try this meat bar out, giggle, giggle, and then just puke all over themselves. It'd be great. Hey, customs, how you doing? So... I mean, I guess I'm going to open up one of these oatmeal bars just for funds, but I don't think I'll be endeavoring to take a bite of this. Oh, no. So, if you could imagine an alcohol, like a liquor that was made from, like, oatmeal... Like, if you were to make your oatmeal in the morning with, you know, sugar and milk, and you make your oatmeal, and then you use that to brew some liquor, that's what that smells like. My mouth is not a sacred place, and that's not even going in there. It's not happening. It's just not. So, I'm going to have to disinfect this area of the table so it doesn't have that granola vomit smell, flavor, taste on it. I don't have high hopes for this coffee. It's feeling pretty stuck to the inside of the package. It's probably all the oil. Actually looks like this is slightly oil stained. So it's probably the oil that came out of these bars. Like, as much as I really want to try a coffee instant type one from 1990 out of one of these rations. That doesn't smell too bad. And that was the last video that Ration Nerd ever made. We're gonna do the same thing we did the last one. We're gonna make a little baby cup. I mean, I still have some of that other coffee. Oh, God, the taste of that granola bar is still, like, meandering around in my face. So that coffee's having a hard time dissolving. That's kind of like tar over there. I'm not doing it, guys. I love you. I want to do it because I want to drink some coffee Instant Type 1 out of a food packet survival from 1990, but... Oh. It's chunky. Alright. Never gonna get to do, well, probably never gonna get to do this again. Oh, yes. That is, it's hideous. Pwah, okay. So, we are going to remove these items from the table because, quite honestly, if the oil from these bars was able to penetrate the packaging of the coffee, it certainly got in this chicken bouillon. It's probably in the sugar as well. Say goodbye to Mr. Oatmeal Cookie. It was fun. Thanks for joining me yet again here on Ration Nerd for a double up food packet survival general purpose. One from 66, one from 1990. Neither one of them survived, even though this one was sealed. These things were not designed to sit around for this long and still be edible. You know, these things are disposable after a certain date, as far as the military is concerned. Once they've passed their expiration date, they just chuck these things. So this has probably been sitting around on somebody's shelf forever, just kind of rotting away, along with the one from 1966. You know, to me, it's not a waste. This was a lot of fun seeing what was inside of these things, kind of imagining what it would be like to actually get my, you know, hungry little paws on something like this that was still edible. Unfortunately, these guys just didn't stand the test of time. But to be fair, they weren't designed to. You know, they're designed to be kept for, you know, 5 years or so and then discarded if they're not needed. So thank you for joining me here on Ration Nerd. This was Food Packet Survival General Purpose. Two for nasty. If you guys enjoy what I do here on the channel, do me a favor, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, talk to me in the chat. It's always good to hear from you guys. Until next time, eat 'em up.